2018 Clovis Invitational, Great Oaks Sweeps Championship Races. Doug Soles, the head coach. Girls looked awesome. I believe it was 90-09, number 9 in course history. Great Oak now owns 7 of the top 11 times in course history. The boys go out and top that. The boys run, help me out here.
76.50,
number 3 all time. And the only two teams faster, Great Oak 2015, Arcadia 2010. Both went on to win Nike Cross Nationals those years. Tell me what your initial thoughts are on the day.
Well, with the girls, we were hoping to get Fatima back up there. She kind of had problems breathing up in Idaho, and so she fell back a little bit, and we figured if she can, you know, rebound today, we'd be good. So she was 6. We were happy with that. We had 3 in the top 7. Obviously, Tori winning is a good feeling. There's some really good girls in there. So she hasn't lost a race yet this year, and she's feeling good, so I'm happy about that. The big thing for us has been whether or not we have a 5th. And we've had a girl that we felt like, you know, would be our 5th if we could just get her ready. She hadn't run cross country before. She was a little nervous. So we've been slowly but surely bringing her along, and she finished 39th today in Aubrey next. And she's slowly but surely picking it up and understanding the sport. So as she gets stronger as the season goes on, I think we're gonna have a pretty tight gap in there and be real hard to beat. So we're happy with the girls.
Now, Great Oak has a 5th already on the girls' side, but you're talking about a Great Oak national caliber, basically different from most schools. Yeah. So it's good it's coming around. How about the boys? A lot of kids that responded really well.
Yeah, we had 4 of our guys had really top-end races today that you know, for their zone. So Ryan Shields, I think, was 18th, and you know, Cameron Hilton finished, 7th? So that was a big, big performance. And then Mateo Joseph, our sophomore, was 15th. But, I mean, the real big show was Tyler Tickner. You know, when he got to 2 mile, I'm getting text messages saying Tyler's leading. You know, we were hoping Tyler would finish in the top 10. So for him to go out and run to win and take second, I think that shows that he's not afraid of anybody. And that's what we try to coach our kids to do, not fear anyone, and just go out and test yourself on any given day. To take second and run 15.08, which I think is the 3rd fastest time for a Great Oak kid on this course, is a really big run for him, so I'm proud of him.
When Tyler came across with the mile to go and he was in the lead, first, my jaw dropped, and second, what stood out is he looked very intense, very dialed in. It wasn't like he was trying to hold on, but like he was still going after it. Yeah. I mean, your thoughts on that?
Well, when Tyler was a freshman, he was the kid that would skip out in the middle of practice and eat French fries over at the Snack Shack. So, you know, we didn't really think a whole lot of Tyler when he came in because he was not real focused on cross country. Then he just started running in and winning races. He wasn't even in shape yet. We're like, okay, maybe this kid's going to be pretty good. And then he bought in. And then once he bought in, he started getting better. So to see him go from the skateboard kid that didn't really care much about cross country at the time, I think mom made him do it, to a kid that's now flying to Oklahoma tomorrow to do a visit, it's an exciting experience to watch that transformation. Went from a goofball to a man, and that's the reason we coach, right there.
So from the French fry guy to the small fry guy, Cameron Hilton has grown so much since he was a freshman.
Yeah.
His growth, both physically and competitively, your thoughts?
Cameron, I think, has grown a foot in the last year. I mean, Jesus. He really, from this time last year to today, he's about a foot taller. So he's filling out, he's becoming a man, and he was always the little guy, you know, the 5-foot kid that everybody was like, oh, he's fast, but he's not very strong. And I told his parents, look, when he gets strong, he's going to be up there. He'll close the gap. And I think he was, you know, 7th today against some really heavy hitters. That's a good sign for our future. And so it's just, you know, his consistency is good, but he's getting faster every race. And I think that confidence is going into it. And he said he came through the first mile in 40th or so, and he said, I knew I could get a lot of these guys. Mm-hmm. So that confidence is there, and that's the big thing. And so we feel good. And we, you know, we're really deep. We feel like our JV is going to really run well, and our frost off is going to run well a little bit later today as well.
If you had to sum it up in one word, a couple of words, what's the theme of the day as to how things went for Great Oak?
You know, I think it's always a little bit of relief, you know, because you run the numbers, you get a feel for what they're capable of doing. And I think the worst feeling is you say, hey, we could break 77 today, and then they run 78.05, and you're like, okay, what went wrong? What am I missing here? So to see them run up to the level of expectation, I think, is the best thing. And to see, you know, a couple guys didn't have great races for what we would expect for them, but the other guys stepped in. I think that's the big advantage. Great Oak's always going to put 7 good guys out there. There's no weakness in the lineup. All 7 guys can run fast. And so if 2 guys have a bad day, 2 guys step up, it evens out and we're hard to beat. So to win both races by over 100 points and very, very loaded fields gives us some confidence for sure.
All right. Great Oak head coach Doug Soles, elite right-hand man Dan Noble. Great staff, great job. Congratulations.
There you go.